Hi, this is Anne-Marie Concepcion from InDesign Secrets. I want to talk to you about how do you prep your final file to hand off to a freelancer or to a printer so that they have all the files they need in order to print that out, make a PDF, or edit it. It's called packaging in InDesign. And what you need to do is, first of all, make sure it says no errors at the bottom. This is a basic live pre-flight check that checks to make sure that all of your fonts are there, all of the pictures are there, your links are working, and you don't have any overset text. So if I reduce the size of this frame, for example, it says, oh, there's an error. You can double click and it says there is a text frame with overset text and it would highlight for you. Very nice. So assuming that everything is copacetic with the pre-flight, let me get this, there you go, then you can proceed on packaging the file. Go to the file menu, choose package, and in the summary panel, it just gives you a summary of everything found in the document. Normally, you don't need to pay that much attention to it, but if you want to look to see what are the fonts and the links and the images and so on, you'll always get this warning symbol, by the way, if anything uses RGB instead of CMYK, which is kind of silly. We've talked about it a lot on InDesign Secrets. There's nothing wrong with using RGB images in InDesign. In fact, sometimes it's the best thing you can do when you export to PDF or print. If the final device needs CMYK, InDesign will do the conversion to CMYK on the fly. Anyway, so let's continue and we'll say package. Oh, we have to save it. I made some changes. Now went ahead and saved it. No little asterisk next to the name indicating unsaved changes. Then we come to this thing that nobody uses, nobody looks at, printing instructions. I wish there were a way to say, don't show me this form. I don't know anybody who uses this. I used to fill it out, but then people told me that nobody read it. So just click continue. This is the dialog box that you want to pay attention to. InDesign is going to create a folder, and in that folder, it's going to put a copy of the InDesign file, a copy of all the fonts in a folder, a copy of all the linked graphics, everything in your links panel. It's going to update the graphic links in there so that the copy of the InDesign file is going to look for those copied images. And then optionally, you can include an IDML file if you're not sure if the person has your version of InDesign. And you can include a PDF, which I find very handy when people do for me, because I can just take a quick look at it in Acrobat or Reader without having to boot up InDesign to get an idea of what they're sending me. I'm going to leave them both turned on. And if you do choose to include a PDF, you can choose which PDF preset to use. That's about it. So I'm going to call this brochure final for printer. That's usually what I do. And click package. You get a warning if you said yes, include the fonts. Okay, the warning says that, you know, whoever you send this document to, they should own those fonts as well. And let's take a look at what it says in our desktop. Here is the brochure final for the printer. There's the InDesign file, the IDML file, the PDF. All the fonts were brought over here. Now, it does not bring over Typekit fonts. So this was the only non-Typekit font used in the document. There's the instructions that nobody pays any attention to. There are the links, and that's it. You can just zip this folder and send that off to your freelancer or your printer, and they have everything they need. Hey, I hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials, and to download a free sample issue of our monthly magazine called InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.